It is a sample that can be used to make reliable statements about the whole population. That means that the process of selecting the sample must have safeguards that ensure we are able to control and minimize potential biases, and to capture the variability of the population as well as possible. To achieve this, the sample needs to fulfill the following conditions. First, the sampling process must have a component of random selection, particularly at the level of the study units that are the center of interest. For example, probability-based sampling at the level of households, if the main interest of the study has to do with indicators of food security at household level. A probability-based sampling process is the best way to address issues of bias in the selection of a sample. By the way, many people use the expression statistical sampling as a shorthand for probability-based sampling. Secondly, the sample size should be large enough to give us a good picture of the variability of the population. A sample of an appropriate size should be able to describe the variability of a population. The most common question asked when designing a sampling study is, what sample size do I need? This tool will help you gathering information that you need to get to a point where you can start to answer this question. Please follow the steps suggested for designing your sampling process. You will soon get to the section about deciding the sample size. Strictly speaking, we should talk about representative estimates rather than representative samples. That is, sample estimates that are unbiased and for which we can calculate margins of error. A sample that has the characteristics mentioned above would give the minimum conditions to get representative estimates. There is, however, one more thing that would be required in the estimation process. It should take into account weights that need to be attached to each observation in our sample. Whether we need to use weights in our estimation process, and how those weights are derived, depends on how the sample has been drawn. This tool will help you keeping a record of the information that will be useful to inform how to carry out an estimation process and how to derive weights. We have also included a short introduction to weights, which can be found in the glossary.